and was not received by the state on the initial email, I believe, on Sunday night when I was made aware of it. So I'm in the process of preparing a response that I anticipate submitting that by tomorrow morning.
Right. So, I mean, because we're not having a trial tomorrow, I'm not available tomorrow to hear a motion tomorrow. So we have to do it Friday morning then before Dr. Bob testifies.
Judge, we actually anticipate, like, we subpoenaed the Seabright officer to be here today. We spoke to Seabright this morning. That's the only officer, I guess, they have on duty today. So they promised that he would be here Friday morning. So if we wanted to, I could call the Seabright officer first. That's not going to be very long. And then do the whatever you prefer.
All right.
If I'm alive.
Well, maybe we'll do the same thing. Have the jury come at 9:30, do the motion at 9, and then whatever, or you call the witness, it's fine.
Whatever you prefer.
I mean, it's a relatively discreet request for relief by the state. It's not a sweeping request for relief. It's only as to a few comments in the report. So,
and I believe, that, like I said yesterday, even if you ruled against us, it's a 2-minute conversation with Dr. Bonnet.
Agreed. Okay. All right, so then today we'll be releasing this jury probably by lunchtime, I would imagine, if not sooner. Any objection if I tell them that regardless of whoever testifies on Friday, I'm not going to keep them all day so they can plan their life, that we're going to let them out of here before the end of the day in rush hour?
Yeah, whatever, like we discussed yesterday, Judge, whatever you prefer.
Okay with the state?
There's no objection, Judge.
All right, I appreciate that. Still nothing from jury assembly. It's 9:26.